Columbia has clearly, and Columbia Engineering has invested a lot in data science and have really built up a whole community of people trying to think about data and its impact.
People don't always think about social work when they're thinking about data science or sciences in general. So they think that I have the technical skills on the data science side. I can just apply it to this social issue without any deep expertise in those areas.
That's Every day you can go and see a new blog post somewhere where somebody says, wow, this technique really goes, really works well for, you know, digit recognition. And so I'm going to use it for criminology or you know, some aspect of society.
You need to understand something about, say, the nature of injustice or inequity broadly, but in your specific area of work, so that you're better positioned to actually do something about that. So the course that I teach, Human Behavior in the Social Environment, is a broad view of how do all these intersecting systems come together to impact an individual's life.
Right. If you are really designing an algorithm that's going to impact society, or designing a machine learning driven product that's going to be used by people, think about what success means. Is success merely the statistical figure of merit, or have you solved some problem for that person, or you have some solved problem for, you know, society, or some from your conception of ethics or values? So think more deeply about what success means, and what even are you really optimizing for. The cost function that you're trying to minimize may or may not be aligned with really some sense of social values or ethical values.
So we try to engage a thought process with our students as soon as they walk in the door that they are not neutral, objective, abstract figures in creating and designing, be it an algorithm or a machine or whatever it is. You are a person making decisions about how to influence society, how to influence people, how to influence the world.
One of the things that we learned in writing this book and in teaching the class was the role of power. And as we went through the history of statistics, right, starting with, you know, Quetelet and Galton and Florence Nightingale and the creation of correlation and regression and eugenics. It was clear that, like, the development of using data to make sense of society was absolutely inseparable from how these people thought society should be designed. By what bias, other than our own hubris, do we look at these data and think that they were somehow not able to be scientists, and we are somehow, above that? Basically, since November of last year, people have been like, intelligence is about a chatbot, and a chatbot maybe that can pass the bar exam or SAT or something like that. 100 years earlier, the creation of the general factor of intelligence just happened to show that the people who were really good at classics and French and other things were the people who were the most intelligent. And it, and even in some of these papers, you can see, and that's why they should be the officers. And some other people should go in the trenches. It's useful to have these references that are so remote, right? They're 100 years ago. We can say, oh, clearly those people are doing it wrong. And then to internalize and ask, but what about the way we are making sense of data? And we do a statistical analysis with so many subjective design choices.
How are we training our students, not only in the technical skills, but are we also training them to think about these other ethics and bias and these other social issues? Pretending that you're objective leads to all sorts of problems, right? In how we use data, how we apply science, how we build and design, et cetera.
One way to think about the role of subject matter expertise is the way that people were talking about data science, at least in New York City, you know, 13 years ago, was that data science was this craft distinct from statistics and machine learning, in part because it was the craft of trying to apply statistics and machine learning to a particular domain of expertise.
It's really transdisciplinary, and that's what's necessary, right? You need people from one discipline coming to another, not just to consult that discipline, but to work together to address those problems. And the thing I like about, you know, the philosophy of transdisciplinary approaches is also it's non-hierarchical. The discovery comes from those people being at the table together.
That's the aspect of data science that's always been exciting to me, is the multidisciplinarity of what happens when you break disciplinary barriers and answer new questions by crossing between different methods or different questions or just different mindsets, and yet finding co-creating value together.
It's an understanding that you need a team in order to achieve this really complicated thing that you're trying to do.